Oh, I'm definitely getting wet today.
Yeah, me too.
It's like a little bit shaky.
We're on a yurt. The lady was living here 8 months out of the year, and a tree fell on her yurt. So now she's selling. We are shooting a waterfall here. Literally gonna be, like, we're selling the waterfall. So I'm getting the drone up now. I'm gonna try not to crash it with all these trees.
How many drones have you crashed at this point?
Honestly, I would say 3. It's just bad. Some of the times I've crashed them are just stupid errors, but today won't be one of those days, so don't you get any ideas there, buddy.
Got this one on. We gotta close all these blinds so we can get the optimal lighting in here. We want it to look pretty cinematic, so. Guys, we got a bit of an interview setup going on. I gotta do a custom shoot for this client for a carpet cleaning business, so just trying to figure out the setup here. And what looks best for the long form content. So again, we try to go for like really cinematic lighting because we got the window lighting over there coming in. So we want to create a bit of a shadow, but it's hard to tell until the client gets here, you know?
Yeah, I'm a yurter. So this is my bathroom here. This is crazy. We got the sink, which actually doesn't have any water. I just have to wait for it to rain, unfortunately. So yeah, and then here's my toilet, which is just a bucket or a fucking can or some shit. Let's keep moving, guys. So we were just shooting the drone and I literally just felt something on my neck and it was a tick. What's that one show, Outdoor Boys? This is my episode.
So we're out here in beautiful Anna Maria, Florida. We shot a $9.3 million listing in Orlando yesterday. And today we are shooting the most crazy beachfront property listed with the Sirhan team at $16 million. We're about to do a cinematic reel for them, hopefully make the property go viral. And this is a huge, huge stepping stone for us getting more into luxury properties, and we're pumped, man. Stay tuned.
I'm actually stuck. All right, made it across. I'm definitely getting wet today. Oh, shit. That was not for the bit. I'm soaked. Yeah. Oh, my God. We got here and I had my sneakers on and we were like, oh, we're gonna go going into the woods. So I was like, yeah, I got my emergency boots, but Ian, he's gonna have to destroy those. So I'm lucky for him. He's gonna need a new pair of shoes after today, for sure.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah. Ian, you were right, man. Yeah.
What's up, guys? We're here at a real estate listing. We're doing photos, video, drone shots, pretty much the full work. So we're gonna give you a little sneak peek of how we do everything and get some behind the scenes footage. Let's go. We'll do it because they don't have railings here. Like every split level they have railings, but they don't have the railings here. So It's like you said, it's kind of like a mini shelf, but it's very scary. If you're just like walking along here, one trip and you're blowing your whole hip out. I would.
Another day, another shoot, guys. Simple as that. But we got new polos now, so. Ian's got the polo on, I got the polo on. I know Mason has the polo on, Carter probably has the polo on, because we just wear polos now. That's how it goes. Garbage cans is a no-no, all right?
I had one drip on me the other day.
We gotta be careful with these, because see how it's crooked? You don't wanna have that, but one time I just completely pulled one and it just broke. I don't wanna go through that again.
So what do you think are the toughest rooms in the house to shoot, typically?
Probably, like, kitchens, because they can just vary so much. Bedrooms are, like, really easy, because, I mean, it's a bedroom. It's just four walls, but kitchens can be random. You never know. But honestly, at this point, I've shot so many houses, like, muscle memory at this point. I just operate like a robot. And so you shoot so many houses, it's like, you just walk in, you just get the angles, and then you forget how you did all of it, so.
What's up, guys? We're out here in Buffalo. We just shot a crazy reel at this three-story waterfront place. You know, we're really trying to level up our video because we kind of dropped the ball last year. We know we can get to that next level. So, you know, we don't have any BTS to show because we were so damn busy and on a time crunch, but we're super excited to start working with agents that care about their video and to level up with them. So let's go.
So I don't know if I said this before with our reels, but they are probably our number one product video-wise. So it's literally just, we take an iPhone, put it on a gimbal, and we walk through the house. Now, they're not as easy as they look. You have to be pretty smooth with your movement, and you have to plan your route, first of all, because it's a one-take video. So you just go through the house, and you edit it so it looks like a super smooth walkthrough. The way I do it is I do a trial run. So I'll go through the house, find out which angles look the best, and then from there, I'll do the main run. Usually for me, it takes like one try because I just go through, boom. And right now we're gonna show you guys what a reel takes. It's really quick, it takes 1 to 2 minutes, and we'll pop up the final product on the screen as I shoot. And yeah, let's watch it. So, come in the room, slow pan here, show off the main thing. And then I would go right to the next room. Around details like tables, I'd slow down. Then I would pan back like this. Gets the scope of the entire room. Notice how I'm moving at a consistent pace the whole time. Come in here, slow down, show the kitchen details. Then I'll go straight through. Detail table again, keeping the same speed still. Come in here, show off this room. Now, if it was a bigger house, I wouldn't show off every single room twice like I just did for this one, but this is a small house and the reels need to be like 30 seconds. So boom, come through here. One more angle of the kitchen. And then this is where I would either cut or honestly just go straight up to the upstairs.
What's up, guys? So that was the first episode of Building the Brand. You know, we really wanted to do this series to pull back the curtain a little bit and show what our culture is like, all the skills that we have, the people involved, and really just be transparent. You know, we do a lot of stuff on social media, we work with a ton of agents, but oftentimes you don't get to see what really goes into the process of making this high-level video and making the photos happen and all that stuff. So we're really excited that you guys are gonna be, you know, able to see this from us. And we have a lot of episodes coming in the future. This was just 1 or 2 months, and there's so much content to get. So really excited to see you guys in the next one, and until next time, peace.